self-care for community health workers. I have come to believe that caring for myself is not self-indulgence. Caring for myself is an act of survival. Audre Lorde. In our role, we have deep connections with the people in our communities. This means that we regularly experience both the stresses of our own day-to-day lives, as well as the stress of concern for those we care for. During a health crisis, such as the COVID-19 pandemic, we experience additional stress related to feeling vulnerable, uncertain about the future, or due to loss and grief. While stress is a normal physical and emotional reaction to changes in life, long-term stress does not allow our body and mind to recover. The experience of long-term stress can lead to serious changes in mood and health. In this video, we will describe stress and how long-term stress affects our well-being, and we will outline steps for management of stress and practicing self-care. Recognizing stress. As community health workers, we can be so focused on caring for others that we overlook or ignore our own stress. But the impact of this stress can be serious. It can impact our mental and physical health and may even make it difficult for us to go about our daily activities. Stress affects people in different ways. When we can recognize stress in its various forms, we can begin to manage it and protect ourselves from its effects. I'll share my own story of working in the community during COVID-19 as an example. When I was caring for people with COVID-19, I was constantly worrying about whether getting the illness would affect my own health. I live with diabetes, and whether it would prevent me from working. At the same time, my sister became very ill, and I was taking care of her son. I was scared for the health of my sister and for the well-being of my nephew. At the same time, I was caring for people who were losing family members to COVID, and I was trying to help them protect themselves from the virus. So many thoughts were spinning in my head over and over again. I had to try very hard to focus on my family and my work. I knew something had to be done. Living with this type of negative stress over long periods of time can result in anxiety and feelings of sadness that can lead to depression. Many people, like me, experience burnout or a feeling of exhaustion that can look like mood swings, feelings of negativity, and disliking my job or people around me. I also noticed the racing thoughts kept me from sleeping, and sometimes I would get irritated very easily or lose focus, forgetting the things I was supposed to do. This level of stress can be a major cause of physical illness too. Without managing stress, people may be at greater risk of high blood pressure, digestive problems, heart disease, and more. Managing a current condition can also become more challenging. For example, even though I was worried about my health, I still had trouble managing my diabetes. While experiencing stress may be a part of our role as community health workers, we need to recognize the signs of stress and learn the tools to cope with these so that we can stay healthy and energetic and create balance in our life. How can we cope with stress and care for ourselves? As community health workers, we need to take time to look after our health and well-being. This is known as self-care. When we take care of ourselves, our ability to care for others in our community improves. The first step to caring for yourself is to be aware of how you are feeling and what aspects of life are contributing to those feelings. We need to keep practicing self-care so that we can get better at identifying what causes the stress and what we can do to reduce it. For example, I noticed that every time I had to leave my nephew in the morning, I would become distracted and anxious as I worked with my clients. I would worry about him, whether he was staying healthy, and whether I would finish in time to meet him after school. Ask yourself, what are the things in your work and in your life that cause you regular stress? How do you feel or respond when you experience this stress? When you know what causes you stress, think about what stresses remain in your control. Are you able to change something to reduce the stress, or can you respond differently to it? You may be able to manage those that are in your control by removing the stressor or changing a routine to reduce your stress. For those stressors that feel out of your control, you can develop healthy ways to react to them. One way to do this is to think about the tools and resources that are available to us. These can be our own strengths or come from our community. When you have identified them, think about how to bring them into your daily life. For me, I recognized that my love for my family and the friends around me could help me change my patterns and cope with my worries. I realized that my colleague and friend, who works a different shift, could walk my nephew home from school in the afternoon, while I could help her in the mornings. I also started spending time with my nephew each day after work, before we called his mother together each evening. Ask yourself, what brings me joy? What or who in my life can bring me comfort or support? Often your network of family, friends, and colleagues can give you support and remind you to take care of yourself too. For example, my colleague not only helped me with my nephew, she also asked about my diabetes and checked that I was taking my medication, getting enough sleep, and eating properly. This helped me to think about my needs too, especially when my work and life got busy. Here are additional ways to protect yourself from stress and care for your well-being. 1. Be kind to yourself. Stress and our ability to cope with it changes. Take your situation day by day. Check in with yourself regularly to see how you are feeling and what is contributing to how you feel. You may want to keep a journal or make sure that you have regular check-ins with a friend or a neighbor. Treat yourself with care and with compassion, like you do with your clients. 2. Acknowledge and be mindful of how you are feeling. It is normal to feel a range of emotions, including being overwhelmed, frustrated, or angry, worried, restless, sad, or tired. It can be helpful to talk about these feelings with others. 3. Find ways to practice positive thinking. It can be easy to feel stress when hearing about illness, lack of resources, and uncertainty about the future. Think about stories of hope in your community, of kindness, and the small joys in your day. You may also want to keep a list of things for which you feel gratitude. This can help to make you feel calm. 4. Remember you are important, and the role that you play as a community health worker is valuable, and you are making a positive difference for others in your community. If you can, raise awareness with your work leadership and community health worker colleagues about the importance of looking after yourself, how stress can impact you, and what we can do to reduce stress. Small acts of self-awareness and self-care can improve focus and concentration, increase motivation, reduce anxiety, and improve overall health. Being able to care for yourself is important and an essential part of being a role model and caretaker for those in your community.